If you have the Samsung Galaxy S24, Galaxy S24 Plus, or Galaxy S24 Ultra, and have noticed any type of issues related to Bluetooth, then I'm going to show you a number of troubleshooting steps to help you fix them in today's video. These issues can include anything from being unable to pair your Bluetooth device, to having difficulty hearing audio playback, and even just frequent Bluetooth disconnects. And it doesn't matter which type of Bluetooth device you have either. The troubleshooting steps that I show you here today can help those with a pair of Bluetooth earbuds, headphones, a connected speaker, or even just a random hygrometer device. There are so many products that rely on Bluetooth for communication, and each of them can run into trouble when you're trying to use them on Android. The first thing that I must recommend is that you do a simple restart. I know how basic it can sound, and it's certainly possible that you have already restarted your phone, whether done for a troubleshooting step or not, since you've been having the Bluetooth issues. But please bear with me, as this simple step alone has shown to help thousands of people who have come asking for help with their Bluetooth device. And we can do this by simply swiping down from the top of the screen twice, looking toward the top and tapping on that power button, and then selecting the restart option here. We're just going to wait for the phone to turn off, boot back up, and then when it brings us back to Android, we're going to attempt to pair the same Bluetooth device, or we're going to test some playback of some audio through that device. Or really, just do whatever you can test to see if a reboot has fixed that issue for you. If that failed to help, then that's perfectly okay because I have a few other suggestions that you want to try. And the next troubleshooting step is resetting your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth devices from within the One UI firmware. And we can do this by first opening up the Settings application. Now we're going to scroll down until you find the General Management option. And then we need to scroll down again so that we can tap on the Reset menu here. And then we can scroll down one last time to reveal the Reset Wi-Fi and Bluetooth Settings option. So we're going to tap on that. You're going to see a blue reset button down at the bottom. We're going to tap on that to confirm that we want to reset that, and you'll get a toast message saying Wi-Fi and Bluetooth settings have both been reset. This is an important troubleshooting step since this saved data can become corrupt over time. Being able to reset this could be the key to finally resolving your Galaxy S24 Bluetooth-related issues. You'll just need to be aware that going through this will delete any saved Wi-Fi network and Bluetooth devices on your device. Clearing out this data is required here, but thankfully you just need to go through the settings area and reconnect to your Wi-Fi networks. Then, pair that Bluetooth device that you're having issues with again, and see if this has helped to fix that issue. If you're still looking for help with Bluetooth, the next troubleshooting step that I recommend you try is to reboot the Galaxy S24, the Galaxy S24 Plus, or the Galaxy S24 Ultra into what is known as safe mode. Now, safe mode will temporarily disable all third-party apps and games that are currently installed on your device. And since there are some times when these third-party apps can cause conflicts with Bluetooth, testing this out while you're in safe mode is a great way to check and see if those conflicts are in fact happening with your setup. And it's quite simple to reboot into safe mode, as we just need to perform a long press gesture on the power off button that's within the power menu. So again, we're going to swipe down from the top of the screen twice, tap on that power button, and then do a long press gesture on the power off button. You can see this green safe mode button now appears, and we just need to tap on that to force the Galaxy S24 to turn off and then boot back up into Android within safe mode. I have an entire video dedicated to troubleshooting Android within safe mode that I can link to down in the video description as well. So it's a great idea to reboot into safe mode and test to see if you're still having Galaxy S24 Bluetooth pairing or connection issues like you were having before. For those of you who are still having the same issues within safe mode as before, the next thing that I would recommend is that you try and reset the cache and app data for the Bluetooth agent application. And this is done by going back into the settings app, scrolling down a little bit so that we can dive into the apps menu. We're going to tap on this sort button so that we can enable the show system apps toggle and then tap on OK. And now we're going to simply scroll through this list until we find the Bluetooth agent application. You should see three Bluetooth related apps: Bluetooth, Bluetooth Agent, and Bluetooth MIDI service. So we're going to tap on Bluetooth Agent. Then from here, we're going to tap on Storage. And now at the bottom of the page, you're going to see two buttons: a clear data and a clear cache. So from here, we want to first clear out the cache for the Bluetooth agent application, and then we're going to clear out the data, and we're confirming that we want to delete that data. We used to be able to do this with the Bluetooth MIDI service, as well as the standalone Bluetooth app itself. But with Android 14, we can only perform these actions with the Bluetooth agent. And that's still proven to help people resolve their audio playback issues, so it's definitely worth trying here. Now, before I recommend you try and perform a factory data reset to fix your issues, let's first test out some Bluetooth related options from within the developer options menu. This is a hidden menu that you'll have to unlock before you see this. So if you have not enabled developer mode yet, which means you do not have the developer options menu at the bottom of your settings application, then please check the video description below for a link to a dedicated guide that I have on how to enable developer mode. You'll want to go watch that, unlock this developer options menu on your device, and then come back to this video to finish it up. Because after developer mode has been enabled, we dive into the developer options menu, and you're going to want to scroll through this list and look for anything related to Bluetooth. Thankfully, most of the important Bluetooth related options are going to be grouped together. So we scroll through this list until you see the default USB configuration feature. As right below it, you should begin to see some optional Bluetooth features. Some Bluetooth brands and devices simply have difficulty connecting to Android when the default settings are left alone. So if you're still having Galaxy S24 Bluetooth issues, then changing some of these could be the key to fixing them. So I would come to this list and start with these toggles. We're going to enable the Show Bluetooth Devices Without Names toggle. Go back, see if you're still having the same Bluetooth issues. And if you are, then you're going to want to come back here and undo that toggle. However, if this fixed your Bluetooth issues, then keep it on. There's no need to come back here. However, again, if you're still having trouble, come back to the Developer Options menu and go to the next Bluetooth-related feature, which is going to be Disable Absolute Volume. And this can help fix the audio levels of your Bluetooth devices. So I would enable this, go back, try to play something over Bluetooth, and see if that fixed the issue. If it didn't, I'm going to come back here, undo that change, and then go to the next feature, which is to turn off the AVC block list. So after enabling that, I go back and test Bluetooth again. We go through all of these toggles before getting to a feature like this, Bluetooth AVRCP version. So the default is likely going to be set to 1.5, like you see here. So we just need to change it to another option within this menu. So I would first set this to 1.3 and then go back and test Bluetooth again. If it fixed it, keep this the way it is. If not, come back here and change it from 1.3 to 1.4. Go back, do your testing, and then come back here if you're still having issues. So you can see we're going to go through all of these. We're going to test our audio codec. We're going to test our Bluetooth audio sampling rate. Basically go through all of these Bluetooth features to see if any of them is able to help fix the issues that you're having. Now, sometimes there's just an Android file system bug that is causing those Bluetooth issues that you're having. And no matter what setting we change or what feature we disable, it's just not going to help. If that's the case for you, then I have to recommend that you perform a factory data reset to try and fix the bug within the operating system. I completely understand that having to set your phone back up all over again can be a complete pain, but sometimes it's actually needed. So we do that by going into the Settings app, tapping on General Management again, tapping on Reset, and then coming down to the bottom to select the Factory Data Reset option. After tapping on it, we confirm that we want to erase everything, and then it will do so after rebooting for you. I have tried to offer every troubleshooting step that I can think of, but it may end up just requiring a factory data reset. Now, if this fails to help, you could need to download a fresh copy of the firmware that you're using and then install it cleanly with a program called Odin. This extra step may be required if Samsung's factory ran into an issue when installing the firmware to your specific device. But that's going to be a last-ditch effort, as a simple factory data reset will likely fix most Bluetooth problems on Samsung Galaxy S24 devices. So that wraps up today's video. I understand that it was a long one, but it's an important video as it has proven to help thousands and thousands of people over the years. If something I mentioned today has helped, then please share which recommendation down in the comment section below. The more people who comment here with their results, the more people that we can help within the community.